The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Marshall. There is, someone once said, no better looking glass than an old friend. The prospect of seeing an old acquaintance after many years is one of the most sublime expectations life has to offer. We anticipate such meetings with delight, it's true, but also sometimes with just a trace of anxiety.
Hank! Hank Murphy!
Yeah?
It's me, Louis Simons. Louis, don't you remember?
Operation Overlord, Utah Beach, the liberation of Paris.
Oh, sure, I remember. I was there.
Yeah. Well, don't you recognize me? Louis Simons, 13th Infantry.
I remember the 13th Infantry.
Yeah, but what about me? I was your best friend. Don't you remember me?
Mystery drama, The Reunion, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Percy Grainger and stars Paul Hecht. It is sponsored in part by X-Lax and True Value Hardware Stores. I'll be back shortly with Act One. "I do not wish to treat friendships daintily, but with the roughest courage," wrote Ralph Waldo Emerson. "A friend is a person with whom I may be sincere." Emerson also noted that a person can count himself lucky if during the course of an entire life, he can forge even two or three true friendships, indissoluble unions of heart and spirit, tempered by honesty, trust, and understanding, and free of jealousy.
Louis, I don't believe you. I honestly don't.
Janie, honey, I've explained it to you 100 times.
But you're actually going to go through with it?
I told you, Hank Murphy and I made a pact. We promised each other that 10 years to the day after we liberated Paris, we'd have a reunion to celebrate.
But you make it sound like the two of you liberated Paris all by yourself.
Well, Hank Murphy could have, just about.
Oh, Hank. Oh, really, I'm so tired of hearing about the glorious Hank Murphy.
We were in the 13th Infantry together. We fought side by side all the way from Utah Beach to Paris.
And because of that, now you're going to Paris without me.
Well, we'll go there sometime, honey, I promise. Hank was the best friend I ever had.
The only friend, you mean?
Hey, Janie, don't say that.
Well, anyway, why do you have to go all the way to Paris? Why can't you just meet here?
Wouldn't be the same.
Well, I'll tell you why. Because you don't even know where Hank Murphy is. Now, look, Louis, if you're such good friends, why haven't you kept in touch since the war?
I told you. Hank was serving some time in the brig when I was mustered out. They wouldn't even let me see him.
Some big war hero. A convict.
He wasn't a convict. Got a little wild sometimes, that's all. He saved my life once. When I was wounded, he crawled through enemy fire. He risked his own neck to save my life.
And got a medal for it, too, I bet.
No, he did it because I was his friend. If only I could ever do the same for him.
So using this noble act for an excuse, you're going to leave me and the children and go off to Paris for a week-long binge like... a couple of adolescents.
Ah, you don't understand friendship. I gotta go, Janie. I mean, what would Hank think?
Louis, how do you know he'll even show up?
He'll be there. We made a pact.
But where's a convict going to get enough money to fly to Paris? Steal it?
He's not a criminal.
Well, he's probably forgotten all about you, and you're going to be standing in the middle of Paris somewhere with egg all over your face.
You don't understand, Janie. I have to go.
Why?
Because... well, because I gotta know whether or not Hank remembered.
Oh, boy. They didn't give you that nickname, Screwy Louie, for nothing.
Maybe he has forgotten. But he saved my life once. I'm not gonna let him down. Maybe you're right, Janie. Hank was just about the only real friend I ever had. So don't you see how important it is to me?
Oh, all right. Don't go if you're so determined. But I hope he doesn't show up. I hope the legendary Hank Murphy turns into a first-class bum, and maybe then you'll stop always talking about him.
Good day, monsieur. Welcome to the Pension Boulanger.
Mr. Boulanger?
Oui. Etienne Boulanger at your service.
you probably don't remember me. I'm Louis Simons.
Louis?
I was bivouacked here during the war.
Louis, of course I remember you. Juliet and I have been waiting ever since we got your letter. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. Hey, you really remember me?
Of course. It's good to see you again. Juliet!
Were you able to reserve number 13?
Harry, your old room.
And the same number as our regiment, the Fighting 13th.
Juliet, Louis, I want you to meet my wife. We have been married now 6 years.
Monsieur?
Juliet, this is Monsieur Simons, the soldier I told you about.
Pleased to meet you.
Just think, Juliet. 10 years ago this very day, Monsieur Simon helped to liberate Paris.
Oh, and what brings you back to Paris now, monsieur?
Well, I've come for a reunion.
Your whole regiment is coming?
No, just one other person.
Oh, la la, how romantic.
You know what?
Well, they say Paris is a lamp for lovers hung in the wood of the world.
Oh, no, madame, you misunderstand. It's my buddy from the service, my best friend.
Juliet, see that Monsieur Simon's room is ready, number 13?
Well, of course. Excuse me, please.
Yeah. In fact, maybe he's already here. Huh? I gave him your address when we agreed to have a reunion. His name is Hank Murphy.
Murphy? No. Just a moment. I will check our reservation. Did I know this, Monsieur Murphy?
No, I don't think so. He was bivouacked elsewhere.
Huh. Well, I have no reservation under that name.
Oh, you don't?
But this is the off-season. Reservations are not really necessary. Perhaps your friend will simply arrive, just like the Fighting 13.
It's true. Hank was pretty impulsive.
Where are you going to meet him? Here at the pension?
The Café Cyrano at 12 o'clock noon.
Oh, well, but it is noon already. Perhaps your friend is there this very moment waiting for you.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I better get over there.
Do you remember the way?
Of course. How could I forget? Café Cyrano. Boy, it's hardly changed at all. Gee, I wonder if Hank will really remember. Hank!
Yeah?
Hank Murphy!
What do you want?
It's me, Louis Simons. Louis! Well, don't you recognize me?
Yeah?
Hey, you're here. You did remember.
Oh, yeah, I did. Yeah.
Yeah, have you been waiting long?
Oh, no, I just got here.
Yeah, well, knowing you, you're probably already 2 drinks ahead of me. Oh, a bartender. Garçon, what are you drinking?
Whiskey.
Two whiskeys. Whiskey for me and my friend. Gosh, it's good to see you. Hey, you haven't changed a bit.
Well, you look pretty much the same yourself.
Yeah, do I? Yeah, I was afraid for a minute there you didn't recognize me. Boy, it's been a long time, eh? 10 years. Whew. I've been working like the dickens. Got my own company now. Hardware store, biggest in New City, and a wife, 2 kids. Hey, we all get along great. How about yourself? Hey, Hank, the sky was the limit, eh?
Oh, I've been doing okay.
Hey, do you remember the last time we were here, eh? Liberation Day. Oh, that was some time, wasn't it? Dancing in the streets, getting kissed by every girl in sight. For one day, we were all heroes. Hank... You know, I wouldn't be here today if it hadn't been for you.
Hey, what do you mean?
Ah, don't be so modest. You saved my life. Don't you remember?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, I was wounded, pinned down by German fire, and you risked your own life to save me.
Yeah, right. That's right, yeah.
Liberation Day. Hey, do you know something, Hank? That was the last time we saw each other. Planning this reunion was the last thing we ever did. And then you got into that fight, eh? And the MPs came.
Yeah, listen, Louis. Where are you staying?
Huh? Oh, at the Pension Boulanger. You remember I gave you the address. They said you hadn't checked in yet. And knowing you, I figured you probably lost it.
Well, what do you mean by that?
Nothing. Hey, well, where are your bags? We'll take them over, get you squared away, and then really cut loose.
Thanks for the drink.
Where you go?
I said thanks for the drink. I don't know who you are, but you stop bothering me.
Hey, Hank, what are you kidding around for?
I'm warning you to lay off.
Hey, it's me, Screwy Louie.
You leave me alone.
Hey, what did you hit me for, Hank? I'm your best friend.
I don't know what you're talking about. I never saw you before in my life.
Room 13 for the fighting 13. Stupid can you get?
Oh, Monsieur Simons, you're back so soon.
Oh, hello, Juliet.
I'm just making up your bed. I'll be finished in a minute.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. Is there a phone downstairs? I want to place a transatlantic call.
You just ask Etienne, and he'll place it for you.
Yeah. No. I can't do that.
Monsieur?
Jeez. I just can't believe it.
What's the matter?
My best friend. And he refused to recognize me.
Yes, but what has happened to your mouth?
He hit me.
Oh, you mean this person you came all the way to see?
Yeah, we were sitting in the cafe, talking over old times. Suddenly, out of the blue, he says he doesn't know me, and he hauls off and slugs me.
Maybe I had too much to drink.
It doesn't make any sense.
Oh, please, let me give you a cold towel.
Yeah, Janie was right. I really am a sad sack.
Janie? Janie is your wife?
Yeah. She told me not to come. She told me I was being silly, that Hank probably wouldn't even show.
But he did, you see. I mean, that's just it. He came all this way, and he hits me.
Well, 10 years is a long time, and people can change.
But Hank, maybe it was just a wartime friendship. I mean, how would I know the difference?
Now you just relax, and this is going to sting. There.
You know, it's funny. I mean, here you are, a complete stranger. You're being nicer to me than the guy I thought was my best friend in the world.
Well, you know what I suggest? That you send a telegram to your wife and ask her to join you. Yeah. You know, after all, why let your vacation be spoiled?
I don't know. I was going to call her, but... Nah, I can't.
Well, but why not?
She'll laugh at me. She said, I told you so. You know what? I should have punched Hank right back.
Well, but perhaps there was some reason.
A reason? For pretending he didn't know me? For hitting me?
Well, maybe he's in some kind of trouble. After all, if he is really your friend, is it right for you to give up on him so quickly like
that? Yeah, you're right. Well, Hank did save my life. I should give him the benefit of the doubt. Yeah, I gotta try to find him.
No, that's better. But you should change your shirt first. Why... Look, you have blood stains on it.
Oh, yeah.
Well, now your room is ready. Please, I will excuse myself.
Yeah, thanks, Madame Julia.
Oh, de rien. And after all, you are a friend of my husband.
The kindness of strangers. If I hurry, maybe Hank will still be at the cafe. That must be Juliet again.
Louis Simons.
Hey, Louie, how the devil are you, you old buddy?
What?
You remembered our 10-year reunion. Oh, come on. Don't just stand there with your mouth open. Put on your drinking shoes and let's go liberate this old town all over again.
A true friend doth sometimes venture to be offensive, said Martin Tupper. But don't think he had in mind a right hook to the mouth. Well, friendship drives a hard bargain. It demands extraordinary patience and understanding. Does Louis Simons have that kind of patience? And what about Hank Murphy? After all, friendship is a two-way street. And so far, his behavior has been anything but friendly. I shall return with Act Two in a moment. 7 years since Louis Simons and Hank Murphy have seen each other. During all that time, they've had no contact. One might almost say it was a miracle that they both showed up for the reunion at all. Well, we know what Louis has been up to, but what about Hank? 10 years is a long time. A lot can happen, and a lot can change.
Louis, you haven't changed a bit. Well, maybe a little less hair, a little more weight. But that's the signature of success, huh?
Hey, Hank, what's going on?
What's the matter? You thought I wouldn't show? Hey, what happened to your mouth?
What do you think happened to it?
Well, you son of a gun. You've already been out raising Cain without me.
Hey, Hank, I think this joke has gone far enough.
Joke? What joke?
Are you trying to tell me you just got here?
Well, I just stepped off the plane all the way from Terre Haute, Indiana. Air travel's the only way to go these days. First class all the way.
Hank.
Hey, I see you grabbed number 13, you sentimental old fool.
Hey, I'm not Louis the Fool anymore.
Well, I'm right next door, room 14, numero 14. Hey, what you hit me for?
That's for the Café Cyrano.
Café Cyrano? I didn't remember that a sock in the jaw was part of the bargain.
Now, come on, Hank. Whatever game this is, stop it.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. In the Café Cyrano, not 15 minutes ago, you pretended not to recognize me. When I called your bluff, you slugged me.
Hey, are you crazy? 15 minutes ago, I was still on my way in from the airport.
Prove it.
Prove it? Hey, Louis, this is your old buddy you're talking to.
No, you've changed, Hank. Now, you never could have made fun of me 10 years ago.
Look, I'm serious. This guy in the bar, it must have been someone who just looked like me.
Someone who looked like you, who had also been in the Fighting 13th, who'd also saved my life.
What?
Hank, I'm not Screwy Louie anymore. I'm not a chump.
Hey, Louie, whatever's going on here, this is obviously no way to begin a reunion. Now, look, this other Hank, was he still at the cafe when you left?
Yeah.
Well, right, come on, then. Let's get down there quick and straighten this out. Well?
Yeah, well, of course he's not here, because he just walked in the door with me.
There's not much light in here. How can you be certain it was me?
You're saying I couldn't recognize you.
Well, obviously not. Why would I want to pull a stunt like that?
Well, you tell me. I mean, how did he know our division number? How did he know...
Hey, wait a minute. He knew about the Fighting 13th?
Yeah.
And he knew about my saving your life?
All the details.
Now, just try to remember. Did he volunteer all this information?
Well, what do you mean?
Or did you?
Well, I guess I was doing most of the talking.
Most of it or all of it?
Well,
In other words, you spotted this guy. You came on like gangbusters and started right in with the reminiscences. And all he has to do is nod his head yes from time to time, right?
Yeah, but...
But what? The guy was putting you on.
Yeah, but...
He looked
just like you.
So? I got a double. It happens. I just hope he doesn't get me into any trouble.
Yeah. It's quite a coincidence.
Louis, do you trust me or don't you?
Look, I'm sorry, Hank. Sure, of course I trust you.
I came in on Alhambra Airlines Flight 41. Now, if you don't want to take my word for it, call the airport and check the passenger list.
Jeez, I feel like such a chump.
Oh, forget it. There's no hard feelings. We both trusted each other enough to show up, didn't we? Well, that's what counts. Ah, come on. Let's go back to the hotel. I want to get out of these clothes and change into my tourist duds. Prison walls couldn't keep me away.
Monsieur Simons.
Yeah, what? Hi, madame.
Monsieur Simons, my husband tells me your friend has just checked into the pension.
Yeah. He's upstairs now. He's changing.
And is everything okay now?
Yeah, okay. It was a case of mistaken identity.
Now, you see, everything works out for the best.
Yeah, that fellow sure was a dead ringer for Hank, though.
A dead ringer?
Oh, it's nothing. No, it means the one guy in my whole life who accepts me just as I am, at face value, and I can't do the same for him.
Well, you'll be all right once you... have the time to, you know, get acquainted again.
Yeah, you're right. We got a great week ahead of us.
Now, can I bring you something while you're waiting to take your mind away from
it? Have you got the afternoon paper?
Oh, yes, it just came. Here.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Oh, sure, of course. It's in French. Screwy Louie. Well, at least I can look at the picture. Hey, what's this? It's a photograph of Hank. Hey, Madame Juliet.
Oh, we must use...
Here, come here. Look, this picture here.
Yes?
What does that caption say?
Caption?
Yeah, the writing underneath.
Oh, monsieur, this is not good.
Well, what's the matter? What is it?
Well, this man is a, this man is a homicidal murderer.
What?
Well, I don't know how you would pronounce this word, monsieur.
That's a schizophrenic.
Well, that means he has two personalities, no?
Yeah, two personalities. The man in the bar, but he spoke perfect English.
What was that?
Yeah, well, what else does it say there?
Well, let me see now. Now, there is a whole story, you must... Why, he is an American. He was a soldier in France during the war.
Yeah, yeah.
He stayed in France after he was released from the army. But he was arrested for killing several people in wild fits of anger the doctor said would seize him without warning.
Killed
people? And the court declared him criminally insane, and he has been in a sanatorium for the last 10 years. But just this morning, he escaped and... Oh, la, la, la. And monsieur is believed to be here in Paris.
Prison walls couldn't keep me away.
What did you say?
Nothing, Madame Juliet, nothing.
Oh,
his name, did I mention his name?
Henri Jones.
Henri.
But...
Henry.
Oh, but they are not sure that it is his real name. When he was arrested, he had forged papers, and they never found the real ones.
Henry. And the nickname for Henry is Hank.
Oh, Monsieur Simons, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Louis.
What?
Well, let's go. What's the matter? I frighten you?
Monsieur, your friend is upset. I'm going to bring him a glass of water, and I'll be right back.
Hey, buddy, are you all right?
Yeah. Hey, Hank, why are you wearing those...
My dark glasses, my shades. Well, they're all the rage back in the States now, I think.
Yeah, but...
Well, I know it's silly. Hey, look, you want to know the real reason?
Yeah.
It's my wife.
Your wife?
Yeah, Linda. She won't let me wear them back home. She claims they're bad for my eyes. But now that I'm free for a few days, the heck with it. I'm going to do exactly what I feel like doing.
Free?
Monsieur Simon.
What?
Now, see, here is some water.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
Is this your friend?
Yeah, I'm Hank Murphy, ma'am, from the Fighting 13th.
And I am Juliette Boulanger.
Oh, pleased to meet you, Juliette. Well, what do you say, Louis? You ready to go over the top?
I'm not sure.
You know where we're going to go first.
No.
The Eiffel Tower.
The Eiffel Tower.
That's right. I've always wanted to see Paris at sunset from the Eiffel Tower.
Oh, monsieur, it is beautiful.
Don't cross me, buddy. My mind's made up.
Look, would you excuse me? I have to make a phone call. Some friends, Janie's. It's my wife's. I told her I'd give him a ring, say hello.
Well, can't that wait?
No, just take a minute.
Oh, there is a phone in the back, right through the door, and Etienne will show you.
Thanks. Etienne.
Oui?
Your phone. Juliet said I could use it.
Over there in the corner.
Thanks. Hello, operator. Do you speak English? Oh, good. I want the Paris airport. Alhambra Airlines. Thank you. Can't believe... Hello, Alhambra.
I
was expecting a friend today, Mr. Hank Murphy, on flight 41, flight 41 from the States, and I was wondering if you could check your passenger list. What? There was no flight by that number. Was there any flight at all that would have arrived or around noon or maybe a little before? I see. Thanks. I can't believe it. It's not possible, not.
So, Louis, is everything all right?
Etienne, I want to call Terre Haute. It's in Indiana, in the States.
Well, I would have to make this call for you.
Yeah, sure. Well, could you do it right away? It's urgent.
I'm sorry. It could take several hours.
several hours.
To make all the connections. Hey, Louis, come on.
What?
Oh, yeah. Look, Hank, maybe we could do it later, okay?
If we don't leave now, we'll miss the sunset.
You know, I don't feel so good.
Hey, pal, you can get sick next week. Right now,
we're going to the top of the Eiffel Tower. All the way to the top.
You may be deceived if you trust too much, said Frank Crane. But you will live in torment if you do not trust enough. Either way, Louis Simons is in torment. Trust is the cornerstone of friendship. But is Hank Murphy a homicidal maniac or the victim of an incredible coincidence? I shall return shortly with our final act. A man saves another man's life. Is that man then bound to his savior? Was it an act of true courage or merely rashness? What is the extent of the debt that is owed? Between friends, such questions are irrelevant. Balancing accounts is something we do with strangers. A friend's credit is infinite, even unto death, is it not? Perhaps, but unto madness as well?
Louis? Louis!
What?
You're white as a clean sheet.
I
know it sounds crazy, but it's important to me.
What is?
The sunset.
The sunset?
From the Eiffel Tower. Where I've been, I don't see the sun very much, you see.
Uh-huh. Well, just where have you been, Hank?
Look, it's getting late now. Either we're going or we're not.
Well, couldn't you go by yourself?
Sure I could go by myself. I can go anywhere by myself. That's easy.
Okay, Hank. Okay, I'll come.
Oh, there it is, Louis. Paris. The whole city at our feet once again.
Yeah. And nothing but this little railing between us and...
I feel like I'm a mile into space.
984 feet, to be exact.
Oh, you always were the exact type, weren't you?
Yeah. No one up here but us.
Hey, what are you standing back there for? Hmm? Come on over here, to the edge. Look. There's a route we took when we marched into the city, remember?
Hank, it's almost closing time. Let's go back down.
Oh, don't be a killjoy. I'm trying to remember.
Look, that's the past, Hank. It's a long time ago.
I know that. I've counted every day. I've had to go to a lot of trouble to get here. I've been looking forward to this minute for a long time, Louis.
Well, what do you mean?
To feel free. To be free again. One last time.
Hank, you're talking crazy.
What?
Nothing. I didn't mean that.
Is that how I seem to you, Louis? Crazy?
No. Really, you're the same old Hank.
No, I'm not.
Sure you are.
Nah.
The guy in the cafe. I mean, he isn't you. Didn't have that old Hank Murphy smile, the old Hank Murphy confidence.
And I do?
Sure. Sure, the old war hero. You remember the saying we had? If you can't make it in the army, you'll never make it on the outside. And who made it in the army if not Hank Murphy? The sky was the limit for you, Hank.
Was.
And still is. Oh, why not? How old are we, 32, 33?
Louis, I've got to tell you something.
Oh, hey, it's all right.
Look, I didn't fly over here this morning.
You don't have to tell me anything.
I have to, Louis.
I don't want to know.
Because it's going to change what you think about me.
Look, Hank, friends don't need explanations.
Friends? Who says we're friends? We haven't seen each other for 10 years.
You saved my life.
So what does that mean? Am I going to bank on that for the rest of my life?
We are friends, Hank. We'd do anything for each other.
Do you really mean that?
Yeah, sure.
You hesitated.
No, I mean it.
But you had to think about it.
Only for a split second, maybe. But you had to think about it. You know what you and I are, Louis. Strangers.
Oh, no, that's not true. I'm your buddy, remember?
I'm sorry, Louis.
Come on, let's go down, okay? This place gives me the creeps.
Me too. Louis, I know it's early, but I'm tired. It's been a long day for me. You won't be upset if I go on up and turn in, will you?
No, go ahead.
Are you coming?
No, Hank, not just yet.
We'll talk tomorrow, okay?
Sure, Hank, sure. Good night.
I guess what I want to say is, I'm glad you came.
Ah, gentlemen, and that was Monsieur Riffel's tower?
Oh, it was real nice, Mr. Boulanger.
And the sunset?
You know, I forgot to look. Well, good night.
Your friend is tired already.
Jen, could you place that call now?
Huh?
The one to the United States, to Terrell.
Ah, oui.
I got to call my friend's wife.
Oh, nothing is the matter, I hope?
No. I want to speak to her.
Do you have the number?
No.
Oh, well, I'm sure it will be in their directory.
Yeah, hope so.
But it could take some time.
I don't care. I got to settle this tonight. I'll be upstairs in my room, waiting.
The police.
What? Yeah, okay. Just a minute. Police?
Inspector Malraux? My credentials?
What time is it?
It is after midnight.
Oh, I must have fallen asleep.
Would you step out into the hall, please?
Yeah. What's happened?
Please, I would like to ask you some questions.
Oh, okay.
Your name?
Simons, Louis Simons. Hey, look, what's all this about?
The person who is occupying the room next to yours, number 14. Did you know him?
Yeah.
He was, in fact, a friend of yours.
Hey, why are you speaking in the past tense?
Because, Mr. Simons, the man is dead.
What?
Look, you must see for yourself.
Hank. Oh, good Lord.
Monsieur Boulanger heard noises from downstairs. He came up to investigate, saw nothing, and was about to go back down when he noticed this blood from the head wound by which this man died had seeped under the floor and into the hallway.
How did this happen?
I thought perhaps you might be able to help us answer that.
Well, of course. I'll do anything I can.
You knew the victim as Mr. Hank Murphy, is that correct?
Yeah.
But you were aware of his other identity?
I knew Hank Murphy, Inspector. He was a war hero, one of the finest soldiers we ever...
Perhaps, but his more recent occupation, which he practiced under the name Henri Jones, was not so heroic.
I knew him as he used to be.
That is very loyal of you. But nevertheless, you knew Hank Murphy and Henri Jones were the same man.
No,
It is no use denying it, Mr. Simons. Madame Moulanger has already told us she translated for you an article in today's newspaper.
Yes, she did.
You knew, yet you did not report this to the police.
Inspector, I couldn't believe Hank would have done such things. I still can't. He saved my life once.
Which is why you took his...
What?
Where have you been since 9 o'clock this evening?
In my room, asleep.
No, it is difficult to prove.
Yeah, how can you think I... Why would I do...
You had the strongest of all possible motives, Mr. Simons. Fear.
No.
Can you honestly tell me you were not afraid of your friend? So, you see, you will have to come with me.
Inspector, I'm glad I caught you.
Madame Boulanger, I am taking Monsieur Simons here to headquarters. I will need his passport.
Just one moment, Inspector. Monsieur Simons, your telephone call to the States, it has just come through.
You mean there was a Hank Murphy listed in Terre Haute?
Oh, yes, and his wife is on the phone, and she's waiting to speak with you.
Inspector, I think we can clear this up right now.
So there were two Mr. Murphys all the time.
There was only one Hank Murphy, Madame Juliet. That I could even have suspected him.
You mustn't blame yourself, Louis.
His wife told me everything. He was dishonorably discharged from the army. No one would give him a job, so he took to crime. One jail sentence after another. He lied to me about flying over because he was too ashamed to admit he had to come by tramp steamer.
But what could you have done?
Well, don't you see? Hank needed my help. He was begging me.
Well, and now it's too late. Oh, Inspector.
Thank you for the use of your telephone. I have contacted headquarters to continue the search for Monsieur Henri Jones.
Well, then you will not take Monsieur Simons to jail, now, will
you? No. Ah. My apologies, Monsieur Simons. I think we can now reconstruct what actually happened. This man you met in the Café Cyrano was the real Henri Jones. From what you said, he realized a man resembling him was coming into the city. He planned to rob this man and then come downstairs, claim his passport, and escape from the country.
Oh, there was a method in his madness.
Yes, but Hank must have awakened.
And there was a struggle in which your friend Hank was killed.
Now, Inspector, how do we know that?
Well,
how can we know for certain it was Hank that was killed?
Well, I suppose we cannot be certain until we check the fingerprint.
Hank was unbeatable in hand-to-hand combat. He wouldn't be killed.
Just one thing, Mr. Simons. Where is he then?
What do you mean?
If your friend kills a maniac in self-defense, he has nothing to be afraid of. Why has he disappeared? Unless he had something more to hide.
I guess I don't know that, Inspector.
I will let you know the results of the tests. But I'm afraid we will find that the dead man is indeed your friend.
No, Monsieur Simons, you must try to get some sleep now.
Yeah. Gee. Hank dead. Oh, I just can't believe it.
Who's there? It's me. Hank.
Hank?
Hank, I knew it.
How did you get into my room?
I came along the ledge. Hey, Louis, you gotta help me.
Yeah, I'm going to, Hank. Believe me.
I just killed a man.
Yeah, I know. That guy was a homicidal maniac. His name was Henri Jones. He's the one I saw in the cafe.
Well, I've gotta get out of Paris.
No, you don't. The police have already told me you don't have anything to worry about. They won't arrest you.
Louis, I've had too many scrapes with the law to trust the cops.
Yeah, but what about the reunion?
Oh, the heck with that.
What?
Look, you go downstairs and you get my passport and you bring it to me.
Well, now, wait a minute, Hank.
Well, hurry up, you fool. There's much time.
You never called me a fool before.
Listen, did I save your life or not?
Yeah?
Okay, so I'm calling in the debt.
Hank.
What? You still don't trust me, do you?
I'm sorry about that.
You still think I'm that Henry Jones character. You've been suspicious of me ever since I arrived.
Hank, I want to make it up to you. I do. Now, your wife told me everything. All you need is someone to give you a break. Help you get back on your feet. And when we get back to the States, I'm going to give you a job.
Yeah?
Yeah? That's a promise, buddy.
Look, you just get my passport, will you?
Okay. Now look, why don't you spend the night here in my room, huh?
Why?
You aren't going to find a plane leaving Paris at this time of night for Des Moines, Iowa, are you?
Okay, pal. Us members of the Fighting 13th have to stick together, right?
Right. I'll be right back. I knew it wasn't you, Hank. You would never have called me a fool. Hank didn't live in Des Moines, Mr. Jones. He lived in Terre Haute.
you're home so soon.
Janie, please don't start in on me.
Oh, honey, I won't. I know what happened.
You do?
Well, Hank Murphy's wife called me this morning.
You know the whole story?
Yes, and I think you did a wonderful thing.
What do you mean? Hank was reaching out to me for help, and I didn't realize it until it was too late.
But, Louie, you did help him.
What?
Linda Murphy called to thank you. You see, just before he left, Hank told her that you were the only real friend he'd ever had.
Hank said that about me?
And that if you didn't show up for your reunion, he was going to jump to his death from the Eiffel Tower.
Reunions rarely come off as they are planned. We burden them with too many expectations. In the case of Louis Simons and Hank Murphy, however, despite all the misunderstandings and tragic coincidences, somehow what was essential was communicated before the end. I shall return in a moment. Was a war hero, and Louis Simons was a sad sack. Yet, after the war, Hank found himself adrift on the outskirts of the law while Louis became a success. Who knows what would have happened to Hank if he'd lived? Perhaps Louis could have helped him, but then again, perhaps Hank's end had already come, even before his tragedy was complete. No one can say what fate has in store for us, but one thing is certain. If we leave it entirely up to fate, we're in trouble. Our cast included Paul Hecht, William Griffiths, Mildred Clinton, and Sam Gray. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Contact, the 12-hour allergy capsule. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.